Where's Jeremiah now?
He's in Smith's quarters, licking his wounds.
All right, let's get him out of here.
What have you got in mind?
Well, that Morty's will has kept the Smiths divided long enough. It's about time we did something to resolve that situation.
Professor Robinson, you are leading me to my grave. Who knows what that fiendish cousin of mine might be planning on next, huh?
We are going to bury the hatchet.
A peaceful solution has already been attempted. As I remember, there were 10 of us cousins alive at that time.
Oh, what happened?
What happened? I can only tell you it made the St. Valentine's Day massacre look like a tea party.
Now, you better let me do all the talking. He may not want to come out if he knows you're with me.
This is a mistake, my friend.
Dr. Smith! It's Professor Robinson! Come on out, I want to speak with you.
Are you sure it's safe?
Absolutely!
We must stand guard against that monster.
No! He's here!
There's no danger.
How little you know.
Now stop it. We're going to have a conference, a peace conference. Your cousin's agreed.
I told you he's going to be unreasonable.
Very well, Professor, you may release me. So, Jeremiah, at long last we stand face to face.
That's right. You put on a little weight, haven't you, Kurt? A lot of gray hair, too.
And you, dear Curls, have never been a prize package. You have aged considerably.
Now we can dispense with the exchange of compliments, gentlemen. We're here to discuss Great Aunt Maud's will.
She always meant to leave her fortune to me.
That's a lie. I was always her favorite nephew.
She always meant to leave her money to me.
After all,
who was at her bedside then?
You were. You were. Your lady'd still be alive, one for you. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if there weren't a little foul play involved.
Are you accusing me? You gave her the medicine, remember? And right after that, she had the relapse?
The coroner's inquest found me innocent.
A full miscarriage of justice. I've known you were guilty for years. Assassin, murderer, monster!
Take that back, I'll take you apart.
I thrashed you when we were youngsters, and I can do it again.
I've got it your nose, and I can do that again.
I want to do that for you!
I'll kill him!
I'll kill you!
Life of ease, millions to do with as I please. Wine, women, song. And all that stands in my way is one puny Smith. If only little Joe would help me.
You gotta help me.
He just got us. Little Joe, it's me, Jeremiah Smith.
So it's you again.
Now don't hang up, Little Joe. You just gotta listen to me.
Okay, what's the caper?
Oh, you always was a real gentleman, Little Joe.
Never mind the buttering up job. Get to the point.
Yeah, sure. Well, now here's the thing. I am due to inherit a great deal of money. Unfortunately, however, my cousin is an obstacle.
You know the Gamblers' Union doesn't allow us to knock anybody off.
Unless he refuses to pay off on an honest gambling debt.
That's a different situation. Besides, your cousin doesn't owe me anything.
But he will. He will, Little Joe. All you gotta do is send down a gambling machine because Zachary is a compulsive gambler. That means he can't help himself.
Keep talking.
He plays the machine. He loses. He can't pay. You eliminate him. I inherit Auntie Morty's fortune and I take care of you.
Sounds all right. But I'm warning you, Smith. This had better work.
This one just can't miss, I'm telling you.
Okay. The machine is on its way.
Short while, Auntie Morty's fortune is gonna be mine.
A life of ease.